Hello friends, so far we have spoken about conventional technologies and the evolution of IT in enterprises, and then we have spoken about big data ecosystem and how big data came into picture with Google. Now we are getting into details of big data ecosystem. As I have mentioned earlier, big data ecosystem is categorized into three. One is batch, primarily Hadoop ecosystem, and the other one is operational, which is NoSQL ecosystem, and then analytics and visualization. And in this video we will be talking about a little bit in detail about Hadoop ecosystem. We'll talk about evolution of Hadoop ecosystem, we'll talk about use cases that can be addressed using Hadoop ecosystem, and also we'll talk about Hadoop ecosystem tools and landscape. So as I have mentioned earlier, due to the challenges with Google search engine with conventional technologies, Google have come up with a new set of technologies which are distributed in nature. They are Google File System, Google MapReduce, and a Bigtable for indexing the content for searching. So GFS, or Google File System, is used for to dump all the data that is crawled over the web, and Google MapReduce is the batch processing framework, which actually process the data that is there in GFS and index them and then dump into Bigtable. So after Google is successful, Google have published three white papers. One is on Google File System, other one is on Google MapReduce, and the third one is on Bigtable. And using those three white papers, a few people from Google, Facebook, Yahoo, and other companies came under one roof under the leadership of Duck Cutting, and they started implementing something called Hadoop, which have two major components. One is Hadoop Distributed File System, in short HDFS, and it is primarily developed out of the white paper on Google File System. And the other one is Hadoop MapReduce, which is developed based on white paper of Google MapReduce. And the term Hadoop came into picture due to Duck Cutting. He got that name from his son. His son's toy, elephant toy, name is Hadoop, and from there he picked up the term and he used as major he brought the term into picture while developing this distributed file system and MapReduce, basing upon Google File System and Google MapReduce white papers. And then after a while, once HDFS and Hadoop MapReduce started shaping up, they also started working on another technology called HBase, which is developed using the white paper of Bigtable. So these all can be considered as Hadoop ecosystem. This is the evolution which we have, which I want to tell you, that Google Hadoop came into picture because of the white papers of Google, and the primary committers of Hadoop is developers from Yahoo, Google, Facebook, etc., under the leadership of Duck Cutting. And then these are the use cases that can be addressed using Hadoop ecosystem. One is ETL or batch processing, second one is real-time reporting, third one is batch reporting, and fourth one is operational but not transactional. You cannot use Hadoop ecosystem or even any tool in the big data ecosystem for a complex transactional based applications. If your application is not transactional but operational in nature, which is in real time, which requires both real-time reads and writes, then you can consider tools from big data ecosystem or Hadoop ecosystem. But if they're transactional, then you have to go with your traditional architecture. So these are the mapping between the use cases to the technologies. Operational and real-time data integration, you can use HBase. ETL, which is typically batch processing. ETL stands for extract, transform, and load. And it is a very common term in the scope of enterprise data warehouses as well as enterprise data integration. especially in batch, and the technologies that can be used for batch processing or ETL are MapReduce or HiveBig and Scoop. So these are the technologies. MapReduce is primarily in Java. HiveBig and Scoop leverages MapReduce. They are functional, you can term them as functional languages, which you can write commands in SQL format or some other user-friendly format or developer-friendly format, and that code will be compiled into Java-based MapReduce programs, and then the processing will be done with that code. So all these are, even though I am saying HiveBig and Scoop separately as MapReduce, these three are developed on top of MapReduce. And then for reporting, if it is batch, you can use Hive. Again, Hive is nothing but a MapReduce. For real time, there are new technologies called Impala and Presto. If you want to do real-time reporting, you can use these things, and also you can actually use HBase as well for real-time reporting. For analytics, you can use MapReduce or many other frameworks. And also, as part of Hadoop ecosystem, there are some complementary or miscellaneous tools like Zookeeper, Oozie, Chef Puppet, and also vendor-specific management tools. They are primarily to manage your Hadoop clusters or to schedule some jobs, etc. But the core tools are here. Means core tools in Hadoop ecosystem are on top, and tools like Zookeeper and other tools will make it more reliable, and they complement the existing Hadoop ecosystem tools. So that is it about Hadoop ecosystem. We'll come back to it again from the context of business use cases, and we will see in detail how Hadoop ecosystem can be leveraged in implementing some complex business problems, in solving some complex business problems using different tools in the Hadoop ecosystem. I hope you are enjoying the series so far. See you in the next video. Thank you. Bye.